youths in the house. What's up? What's up?
Yay, yay.
We want to just let you guys know that we are very proud of you guys. You guys ended the school year on something that no one has ever done. You guys ended the school year with your family and friends. You guys stay within your reach, you know, and you guys are healthy.
Right.
And God loves you guys. And always remember that no matter what you do it with the love of Christ.
Amen. And just to add to that, guys, I just want to let you know that let not your hearts be troubled. That's what the Bible says. If you believe in God, also believe in Him, Jesus Christ. So when you're going through this type of situation, not able to walk on stage and not have everybody in your surroundings, when you're walking on the stage, just let you know that we're all here with you. And just let you know you got your whole life ahead of you. Don't stop. Keep going. You know, we may fail at times, but you know what? Get back up and keep running for that success that you've been reaching for. Yes. God bless you.
Congratulations.
Praise the Lord, everyone, and welcome to Straight Gate Apostolic Worship Center's live stream worship experience. I'm Bishop Philip Grigsby, and we welcome you here today. For this is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Listen, if you have not liked or shared this video, I want you to do so right now. Like and share this video. Listen, we have a powerful service, and God is going to bless us on today. We're expecting God to do some great things. Let's go into the sanctuary right now, and we'll see you soon.
Lord God, we come to you this morning, Lord, that valley and I wait. Heavenly Father, we believe in your word. Hallelujah, you've been our ever-present help in a time of need. All power is in your hand, move in a mighty way. Touch and deliver right now, O Lord, and we'll bless your name. Bless those that are watching, Lord, move upon them, O God. Let them be a blessing to those in their area as we be a blessing to them. Now, Lord God, come by here. Bless us, O Lord, as we minister to them in the mighty name of Jesus. We know that thou art God and all power is in your hand. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you one more time. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Yeah.
live stream worship experience. We're so glad to have you with us on this morning, but this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us all rejoice and be glad in it. We are so glad to have you. We hope you've liked this video and have shared this live stream, because we want others to be blessed by what God is saying at this time. Get your Bibles ready and let's prepare to go into the Word of the Lord. I'm Bishop Philip Grigsby, and I'm so glad that you have joined us on today. We're going to the book of James. Yes, let's go to the book of James and the first chapter. James chapter number 1. We're going to go down to the first verse. We'll jump around a little bit, so just follow me. But get your Bibles ready. Get your notebook ready. And let's go into the Word of the Lord. James chapter number 1. Let's begin by reading the first verse. James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad, greeting. My brethren, count it all joy when ye fall into divers temptations, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. But let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. I want you to jump down with me. Let us read verse 8 quickly. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Let's jump down to verse number 12 as we conclude our opening text for this morning. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to them that love him. I want you to bow your heads with me at this time. Father, we thank you for the Word of the Lord. We thank you for being our keeper, our protector. We thank you, Lord, for everyone that is watching on this Sunday morning. And we pray right now, God, that you would strengthen them right where they are. Touch them. We're so grateful that you protected them as we are living in times filled with uncertainty. But though we're living in times filled with uncertainty, we serve a certain God who will always see about his people and will protect us and keep us under your precious blood. Bless us on today. Speak through your vessel. Speak through these lips of clay. And let someone be edified by the Word of the Lord. In the matchless name of Jesus Christ, we pray this prayer. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Today, our key verse will come out of James chapter 1 and verse number 12. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to them that love him. Today I want to come this morning with a topic. I've got too much to lose. I want you to type that right now. I've got too much to lose. I can't give up now. Hiya, glory. Because I've got too much to lose. I've got
got too much to lose. Our text this morning introduces us to a man by the name of James. The Bible lets us know that James is also referred to as James the Just. Who is James? James was the oldest half-brother of the Lord Jesus Christ. But he was the full brother to Jude. James, due to his relationship with Jesus Christ, had a unique perspective, knowing that he was the half-brother of Jesus Christ, makes his introduction and epistle even more significant. I've come to find that those that really know God are those that are qualified to tell others about God. James was in the inner three with Peter and John. He was able to see things that the other disciples did not see. And as we look in the book of James, we find that it is simple, yet organized and logical on the ethical aspects of the Christian life. The major theme of the book of James appeals to the believers that true faith results in outward acts of obedience and righteousness. If I can say that again, true faith results in an outward act or outward acts of obedience and righteousness. As we look, we find that James introduces himself as a bondservant. Did not introduce himself as the half-brother of Jesus Christ. Did not introduce himself as the Apostle James. Did not introduce himself as the James that was at the Transfiguration. But he refers to himself as a bond servant. Look at the humility of James in his introduction. He translates this word as being a bondservant. Instead of calling himself the apostle or calling himself the half-brother of Jesus Christ, understanding the meaning behind bondservant. In the Greek, bondservant is pronounced doulos, which means slave, which means one who is in a permanent relationship of servitude to another. He was letting us know that as being followers of Christ, you cannot be a temporary follower of Christ, but you've got to be a permanent follower of Jesus Christ. But he refers to himself as a bondservant, knowing the meaning tied to it, is a slave. Not in a negative sense, but in a positive sense. Serving the master that we serve, we find joy and peace. And we find that he takes care of us every day of our lives. Then we see in verse number 2 through verse 3, he says, count it all joy when you fall into divers temptation. Can I tell you today that when we talk about that word fall into diverse temptation, of course, diverse represents different or many. Many types of temptations. But we understand that when we talk about falling, it's referring to being surrounded by diverse or different types of trials. But look at what he tells us. The trials that we experience, they don't come to break us. For some said they don't come to break us. There's a certain attitude we should have when going through these trials. But he lets us know that trials come to worketh patience. The Greek word for patience is hupomone. It describes not a passive endurance, but an active endurance. Let me say that one more time. It describes not a passive endurance, but an active endurance. You got to stay in the race and endure, because he that endures to the end shall be saved. But look what he says in verse 3. He deals with the testing of your faith. Somebody type that. My faith has to be tested. Type it right now. My faith must be tested. Faith is tested through the trials that you experience. Trials reveal the type of faith you have. It's easy for us to stand up on Sunday night and have a testimony service and testify about how much faith we have in God. But then the next day, you find your faith being tested again. We see here that trials reveal what type of faith you have. Not because, watch this, not because God doesn't know how much faith you have, but so our faith will be evident to ourselves and to those around us. Let me park the car to the curb right here and tell you that the faith that you have is for you to grow in it and for others to see that you have it. Somebody type, I have the faith. And as we continue looking here, we find that only precious things are tested. I feel like running. But only things that are precious are tested. And faith is tested. It shows, amen, that faith in our text, it lets us know that faith is as vital to salvation as the heart is vital to the body. I'm going to say that again, because some of you missed that right there. Faith is as vital to salvation as the heart is as vital to the body. How is that so, Bishop G? Well, without the heart, the body cannot function. Without the heart, the body dies. Well, the Bible says that without faith, it is impossible to please the Lord. You've got to have faith. And when you have faith, your faith shall be tested. But it also lets us know that trials reveal what faith you have. Now watch this here. Trials don't produce faith. No. They don't produce faith. But supernatural faith is built in us as we hear. Because faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Let me say that that trials don't produce faith, but faith is built through the hearing of the word. That's what the Bible says. And as we find out, as going down in the text and dealing with verse number 5, he deals with wisdom. Yes, trials, in trials, wisdom comes. Wisdom, amen, connected with knowledge. Knowledge is raw information, but wisdom knows how to use it. I can run right there. Knowledge is raw information, but wisdom tells us how to use it. It's one thing for me to have the word of God, but I've got to have the wisdom to know use it. Hallelujah. Somebody tap that right now. I've got the word. I've got the word. I've got the word. Knowledge is the ability to take things apart. But wisdom is the ability to put things together. My God, today, I said knowledge is the ability to take things apart. But wisdom is the ability to put things together. I know this, but he says in verse 6, he says, and then he talks about the word wavering, 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 wavering. Your faith should never waver, because when we're talking about that word waver, waver ties into the waves of the sea, and the waves of the sea are unstable. The waves of the sea are driven by the winds. But James is telling us that we are to have faith that is not moved by the winds of life, nor moved by the trials we experience. But our faith in God is sure, knowing that the same God that saved us is the same God that will keep us. Somebody type, I know he'll keep me. Come on, type it, I know he'll keep me. God did not save me so that I would remain a victim. But when God saved me, he made me the victor, gave me the victory. Can I get a witness? Gave me the victory. And I want you to know, brothers and sisters, in dealing with the text, that we find that there is a special blessing. A special blessing. Verse number 12 tells us there's a special blessing that comes from God. Never try to put God in a box. Why would you put God in a box thinking he can only bless you with earthly blessings? God is an eternal God, and the blessings he wants to give you are eternal. Now, I do want you to know I appreciate God blessing me with earthly things. That's a promise that he made to us. In Matthew 6:33, remember when he said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things, not might we, but shall be added unto you. God wants to bless you, and I want you to know that God wants to bless you. Yes, he'll bless you with a car, but can I get a witness to say it's bigger than that? He'll bless you with a brand new job. Yes, he will, but I need somebody to type it's bigger than that. He'll bless you with a financial blessing. But I need somebody to type it's bigger than that. An eternal God can not only bless me with earthly blessings, but the eternal God wants to bless me with eternal blessings that will bless me for eternity. I feel like giving God praise right now. Can somebody type, God's got a blessing for me? Somebody type it right now. God has a blessing for me. Glory be to God. I'm almost through here. And then we're going to take it to church, Brother Trey. But the Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians chapter number 9, we find in the 24th verse that the Apostle Paul says, know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receiveth the prize? So run that ye may obtain. And then he says in verse 25 in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, he says, and every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a corruptible crown, but we an incorruptible. I want you to know, my friends out there watching, that God wants to bless you with an eternal blessing. But in order for you to get what he really wants for you, you gotta keep on running in the race. And you gotta make up in your mind that you've got too much to lose. Can I get somebody to tap it right now? I've got too much to lose. I'm gonna read one more verse with you. And we'll go to church. It's in 2 Timothy and the 4th chapter. It is there in the 7th verse and the 8th verse that Paul is getting ready to go off of the scene, and he's charging his young protege by the name of Timothy. He tells Timothy, he says, I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. I want to stop right there. Paul remembers all he went through. Being stoned for being a preacher. Being thrown in prison for casting out a devil. He remembers being bit by the viper, but not being poisoned. He says, look what he says in verse number 8 of 2 Timothy chapter number 4. He says, henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day. And not me only, but unto all of them also that love his appearance. I want you to know that you've got to make up in your mind that after God has saved your soul and after everything he's done for you, you've got to make up in your mind that all your body, mind, and soul, everything that's within you will serve the Lord. And you realize that you've got too much to lose. Let's take it to church, Tree. Let's ride. You've got too much to lose. After all that God has done for you, you make up in your mind that blessings that are earthly blessings, they're all right with your earthly body. But there's something that God has for you waiting on the other side of eternity. He has a crown of life that is waiting for you. But you got to make up in your mind that you've got too much to lose. Even when the going gets tough and the going gets rough, you got to make up in your mind that you've got too much to lose. I've been going through the fire and I've gone through the storm, but the only reason angels. There's a mansion in the sky that's waiting on me. I've got too much to lose. I want to walk the streets of gold. I've got too much to lose. I would give up right now, but every time I think about giving up, something within me reminds me that I've got too much to lose. I've got a crown of righteousness waiting on me, and I came to tell you that the mansion in the sky, that's all right. The streets paved with gold, that's all right. Seeing all the other believers, that's all right. The crown of righteousness, that's all right. But is there anybody out there that really wants to see the main thing? And I came to tell you that the thing that I really want to see, all I want to see him, to look upon his face. I want to see the face of the man that died for me. I want to see the face of the man that rose from the grave for me. I want to see the face of the man that pulled me out of darkness, washed me in his blood, filled me with his spirit. I want to see him. I got too much to lose. I know things are crazy right now, but I want to tell you, hang on in there. You got too much to lose. Keep on going. You got too much to lose. Keep on fasting. Keep on praying. Keep on holding up the flesh came down. Hold up the word. Walk in the word. Apply the word. Speak the word. You got too much to lose. God gave you the power of the Holy Ghost so that you would be able to step on serpents, so that you would be able to walk in faith, so that you would be able to overcome every lie, overcome every storm, overcome every whisper, overcome every slander, overcome every trial. And when the Lord says, come my people, don't make the rapture, but you gotta hold on, stay strong, don't give up. If you gotta cry, let the tears run down your face. Why you keep on praising God? Let the tears run down your face. Why you keep on fasting? Let the tears run down your face. Why you keep on looking at Jesus and declare, I've got too much. I've got too much. I've got too much. Too much to lose. I can't give up now. I've got too much to lose. Trials come. But I won't let trials stop me. I've got too much to lose. I've been up, I've been down. I could have gave up a long time ago. Do I have a witness up there? You could have gave up a long time ago. But you got too much to lose. Somebody type that one more time. I've got too much. I've got too much to lose. I can't give up now. He's been too good to me. He's been too kind to me. I've heard what's on the other side. If I just hold on a little while longer, I've got too much to lose. Bow your head with me. and string, holding on by a thread. But God, I pray that you would give them strength right now. Give them power right now. In the matchless name of Jesus, we declare on this day that we have too much to lose. We have too much to lose. We have too much to lose. Too much to lose. I want you to help me sing. If you know God has been good to you, help me sing this. Lord, you are good.
Praise the Lord, everybody. My name is Minister Trey Perry, and on behalf of Straight Gate Youth Department, I want to congratulate all the 2020 graduates. You did it. Great accomplishment. Great achievement. You guys are amazing. The sky is the limit. Always remember, no weapon formed against you shall prosper.
Again, everyone, we pray that you were blessed by today's service. Didn't the children sing and they really ministered today? How great is our God? We pray that you were blessed as well by the presentations given by our youth pastors and our youth president. Listen, our God is so wonderful. He has given us a reward that we can't see, but we know awaits us. Therefore, we have too much to lose. Heaven is ours. We just have to continue to press on and stay in the race. I want to quickly give you our giving information at this time. If you want to give on Cash App, it is $SGAWC, all capital letters. That's on Cash App. And on PayPal, it is PayPal me, lowercase letters, SGAWC. Listen, we are very aware of what's going on in our land today. We have the pandemic of COVID-19, and we're still experiencing the pandemic of racism. Listen, we want you to know that the thing that will bring all of us together is the love of God. If we would love one another, like Christ tells us to love one another, I promise you, we'll find that love is the cure. I'm praying for you today. I want you to be encouraged and keep your eyes on Jesus Christ. Well, we're getting ready to sign off at this time, but we want you to meet us here next week at the same time, live at 10:45. And remember, there's life at the gate. God bless you.